Yes!
In the Gospel of St. Matthew, the 11th chapter. There'll also be one out of 2 Peter, the 2nd chapter. But the Gospel of St. Matthew, the 11th chapter, I begin reading at verse number 20.
Amen.
Glory.
It says, then began he to upbraid the cities wherein most of his mighty works were done.
Yes.
Because they repented not. Woe unto thee, Chorazin. And woe unto thee, Bethsaida. Mm-hmm. For the mighty works which were done in you,
all right,
had been done in Tyre and in Sidon, they would have repented long ago.
Yeah.
In sackcloth and ashes.
Yeah.
But I say unto you, it shall be more tolerable.
Yeah.
Tyre and Sidon at the day of judgment.
My Lord.
Than for you.
Yeah.
And thou, Capernaum, which art exalted unto the heaven, shall be brought down to shall be brought down to hell.
For
out of the mighty works which have been done in thee have been done in Sodom, it would have remained until this day.
Yes.
But I say unto you that it shall be more tolerable for the land of Sodom and the day of judgment than for thee.
Yeah.
2 Peter, the book of 2 Peter, that's way back in the New Testament scripture, really back in the book of 2 Peter, the 2nd chapter. 2 Peter, the 2nd chapter. Verse number 4 says, for if God spared not the angels that sinned, but cast them down to hell, delivered them into chains of darkness to be reserved unto judgment.
Yeah.
And spared not the old world, but saved Noah, the eighth person, a preacher of righteousness, bringing in the flood upon the world of the ungodly, and turned the cities of Sodom and Gomorrah into ashes, condemned them with an overthrow, making them an example unto those that after should live ungodly, and deliver just Lot, vexed with filthy conversation of the wicked. For that righteous man dwelling among them in seeing and hearing vexed his righteous soul from day to day with their unlawful deeds. The Lord knoweth how to deliver the godly out of temptations and to reserve the unjust unto the day of judgment to be punished.
Yes.
but chiefly them that walk after the flesh in the lust of uncleanness and despise government. You ought to read the rest of it. I'm just not going to bore you today. But for a subject, a simple subject, you can remember this. Sodom didn't have churches. Sodom, we read of it in both scriptures, did not have churches. In our first text, Jesus, the Son of God, the Savior of the world, the Word that became flesh, the Spirit that leads and guides us into all truths, Jesus the Christ, who had taught his disciples, poured all of him into them, and demonstrated time and time again the power of God, and revealed to them the truth that lied therein. Wanted to show his disciples and the world, and told them to record it for you and I.
Thank you.
That to whom much is given, much is required. Those, he said, who have seen a lot of light are more responsible than those who have seen little or no light. And the latter chapter of St. Matthew is a perplexing chapter in that. I remember when I was a teenager, they used to have a saying that went for almost anything. It was a catch-all saying, and it just would tell you the wrong answer. Y'all understand? And many times when they would use that saying, nobody had asked the question. Perhaps some teenage boy would tell his mama, he's been to go down, I'm going to run down to the store. And she might just say wrong answer. In other words, that's not the response. That's not what, in other words, what you're saying is not accurate. And not only is it accurate, but it doesn't go right there where you just put it. Jesus was having a problem with the people of the world who were given an improper response to everything that he had done. And when he performed miracles and did healings and gave blessings, and folks still refused to believe on him, it became time to show men how they thought. Not just showing that he knew how they were thinking, but he was showing how they should have been thinking. We just are a people sometimes who just don't have the proper response for whatever action has taken. They've said in school that every action causes a reaction. And if that be true, sometimes we just tend to give the wrong reaction. Y'all ain't saying that. I've known folks who have had husbands or boyfriends or whatever what you call them who look like the more they beat them, the more they love them. Y'all ain't saying that. And their logic is, I know that don't make sense to you, but just look like the more you beat me, y'all ain't saying that. The more I love them. Some of us just have a hard time being faithful to folk who are faithful to us, but we're going all in for somebody that don't care nothing about us. The job that will do the least for us, y'all ain't saying, give us the least benefit, that's the one that we find ourselves being more faithful to. The person who disregards, disrespects us, who the child that bring them the most grief look like just get treated like the golden child. Y'all understand that? Just the improper response. It just seemed like the one that brought the most joy would be the one that you did the most for.
Amen.
But yet, we are people by nature that just give an improper response.
Yeah.
Folk who try to be kind, we walk all over them.
Amen.
And yet cling to folk.
Now.
Who let us know up front, I don't entangle, he play like I'm nice. Y'all ain't
saying
that.
Amen.
Jesus, who at the onset of his earthly ministry, received the grand introduction a presentation from John the Baptist.
Yeah.
All right.
Now the setting of our text, the Bible said King Herod had put John in prison.
Yeah.
Wow.
And John sent some of his disciples.
Amen.
And told them to go and ask Jesus, is he really the Messiah? Is he the one? Or should we look for somebody else? Did I tell you John was the one who introduced him? John was the one that made the big presentation. You know what he said. Behold, the Lamb of God which takes away the sin of the world. And now John is in prison. And it seemed like that Jesus always said that. It just seemed like if Jesus was who I thought he was, he would not allow me to sit here. The fact that Jesus did not do what John thought he should have done caused John to fall in doubt.
Amen.
Some of us got envisioned what Jesus ought to be.
Yes.
What God ought to be. And when he don't fit that mold for us, y'all understand? It causes us to also be in doubt.
Amen.
Jesus simply told his disciples, you don't have to give John an answer of yes or no. But just go and go back to John. And show him again the things that you hear and see.
Amen.
Yes, right.
You understand? Make John know that the blind been you're in prison, but the blind been receiving their sight. So just because God ain't doing what you think he ought to do, God's still doing some stuff.
Yes,
and you line yourself up with God, you can experience some of the blessings and the benefits that God has in store. You should go and show him. That the blind receive their sight.
Amen.
That the lame now can walk.
Glory.
The lepers are cleansed. The deaf can now hear. The dead are raised. And the poor had a gospel preached to them. And blessed is the person who is not offended in Christ. And the Bible says that as they departed to go deliver the message to John, Jesus thought of a good time to bring to their attention how they constantly keep giving the wrong response. And he pointed out that he understood John's question. Because John thought that not only was Jesus coming to save the world, but he thought that Jesus was coming allowed to overthrow the Roman government. And the mindset was that if he in fact is going to overthrow the Roman government, it just seemed like he'd do it and get me all out of prison. And Jesus had to correct them concerning John. Make them understand that just because John doubted that it did not discount him.
Amen.
Or did not disqualify him
because
he had a moment of doubt.
Yes.
It's one thing to have doubt in your mind about God. But Satan's objective is to make you have continual doubt about God.
Yes.
You understand that it's one thing to doubt whether or not God is going to do this one thing for you, but it's another thing to doubt that God even is real.
Yes, he is.
For the scripture says, church, without faith, it's impossible to please the Lord. But they that would come to him, God, first believe that he exists. And that he is a reward of them that diligently seek after him. And so Jesus raised the question and asked them, when John came on the scene, when y'all went out in the wilderness to hear John preach, Jesus asked the question, what were you looking for? He said, well, you're looking for a reed shaken in the wind. You understand? That's indicative of a prophet, our man, that just go with the flow. You understand? When folk like what you're preaching, you just keep preaching it. And if they don't like what you're preaching, you don't preach that no more. He says, is that what you were looking for? You're looking for somebody clothed in soft raiment. And then he said that contrary to what John was, the people dressed up and decked out belong in the palace. But John was a voice crying in the wilderness. And then Jesus asked him, were you looking for a prophet? And then he said, and more than a prophet. Jesus quoted the scripture out of Malachi that said, behold, I send my messenger to prepare the way before me. And he said, verily, even though John is in doubt right now, he said, there's not been a man that was born of a woman that is greater than John the Baptist. He said, nevertheless, my Lord, he that is least in the kingdom of heaven is greater than John. And Jesus was reaffirming that John was the right one. But what he was saying was that they had the wrong response. For Jesus said, shut, my Lord, why can I compare this generation? He said, it's like little children who play games in the market. And you know how you play house. Y'all ain't sound when somebody ain't playing right. You have to remind them how the game goes. He says, like little children playing in the marketplace and calling to their fellows and saying, we done piped and you did not dance. You understand when we play in house, y'all ain't saying that. And we make the mud pies. You gotta at least act like you eat the mud pies. Y'all ain't saying that, because that's part of the game. And what they're saying is that while we were playing, and we act like we were blowing the pipe. Y'all ain't saying that. We piped, but you didn't dance. We did our part, but you didn't do your part. He said, it's like that. Saying, we're mourning, and you living it now. And then look what Jesus said. John came, and he wasn't eating, not drinking. John wasn't a part of it. He didn't drink wine. He wasn't socializing and throwing parties. And y'all said John had a devil.
Yes, they did.
Don't miss this. John wasn't socializing. He wasn't turning up. Y'all act like you don't know what I'm saying. He wasn't turning up. And y'all said he had a devil.
That's right.
This Son of Man, Jesus came. Eating and drinking. And they said he's gluttonous. A wine bill. And a friend to publicans and sinners. But wisdom, he says, is justified of a child. In other words, some folk, no matter what you do, they're always looking for an excuse. I won't go to church, but church lasts too long. I would go to church, you fill in the blank. But the church folk ain't doing nothing but hypocrites.
All right. Yeah.
I would go to church. Yeah. But it's too much mess in the church. Yeah. Folk got all kind of reasons for not coming to church.
Yeah.
Well, you taking somebody's word for it.
Amen. That's right.
I hear folk talking and accusing the church when I've never known they even go in the church. Y'all ain't saying that. And if you come in the church looking for a reason to go back out the church, you'll always find one.
Right. Yeah. Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
We come to church, this is God's house.
Yes, it
is. It's God's business.
Amen.
And it's God's service.
Yeah.
And I marvel at the fact that our response is, if there's something we don't like, something don't set well with us, then that's enough for us
to walk off and leave.
Yes. And then think it's excuse enough for our denial.
Yeah.
Listen to what Jesus said, woe to thee, Chorazin, and woe to thee, Bethsaida. These towns are significant because these towns are surrounding where Jesus did most of his miracles.
Yeah.
His headquarters, which was in Capernaum, and all of these were located about the Sea of Galilee.
Yeah.
And what Jesus is saying is that they saw miracles that nobody else saw.
Amen.
They saw him do things that were designed to prove that God really was alive.
Yeah.
And the more he did for them, the more they rejected him.
Amen.
In fact, in his own hometown, the scripture said he could not do many works there because of their unbelief.
Amen.
Why are you trying to remember the 23rd Psalm? I think that's a verse worth remembering.
Yeah.
Because of their unbelief, he could not do many works. If you want to see God do some works, you got to believe. So Jesus was charging them.
Yes.
And when we hear the term, whoa. That's never a good word. Ain't no way to say whoa and make it be a good word. If you get your best soprano to say it, whoa, it's still a bad word. Whoa!
All right.
For wrath. And woe to you, Bethsaida. Bethsaida, the home of four of Jesus' original disciples who had seen Jesus perform many miracles.
Amen.
Heal the centurion's sight. Give Peter, mother-in-law, heal her fever. Feeding of the 5,000. And many light miracles. Where the blind man asked Jesus to touch his eyes. And he looked up, Jesus spit on the ground, anointed the man's eyes. And asked the man, could you see? And, and the scripture said the man told Jesus, I see men, but they look, I see them as trees. They just look like walking trees. Sometimes some of us have been touched by God, but the touch we got wasn't enough. It wasn't effective enough. You should not have stopped there. If men look like trees, trees don't have souls. You don't have to love trees, but you got to love mankind. And Jesus touched the man again. Suddenly, I'm convinced you just need another touch. Church is just a place to go have a good time. You don't see church as a place where I need to go once in a while. You don't see church as a place where I can only drop by, but I can't really put no time in. You need another touch.
Mercy now.
has seen the miracles of Christ.
Yes.
Then he compares Bethsaida and Chorazin, two cities that were right near one another, with two Old Testament cities that were also very close.
Amen. Yeah.
Tyre and Sidon. If you read Isaiah, Jeremiah, Ezekiel, or Amos, or any other prophets, you're bound to find some doom prophecy for both Tyre and Sidon.
Yeah.
They were known as witnesses that did not know God and did not regard God. And Jesus said, even though they were wicked cities, in fact, one of them is where Jezebel was from.
Yeah.
And don't you fool yourself in thinking they couldn't do something wicked.
All right.
Jezebel was some kind of wicked according to the scriptures. But Jesus said, in spite of how wicked these towns were, if they had seen the mighty works of God that you see, they would have repented a long time ago. You understand that?
Yeah.
They had seen him give sight to the blind.
Yeah.
See, this is the thing about God knowing the hearts of people.
Yeah.
He can judge before and after judgment.
Yeah.
So he already knows the heart of these people. And if these people had had the same opportunity that you have, that's what he's saying.
Yeah.
They would have accepted God. But your hearts are so hardened. Your mind is so blocked. You've got so much pride that you just keep on rejecting God.
Yeah.
That's what he's saying.
Oh, God.
The time side on.
Oh,
even though they got a bad night.
Yeah.
Flip all through the Old Testament.
Yeah.
They got a bad night.
Yeah.
But what Jesus is saying, if you had put them in the New Testament, instead of the Old Testament,
mercy, Lord.
They would have seen the goodness of God.
Yeah.
And would have trusted him. Some of us, I don't know what it's going to take.
All right.
The Lord has been good to us. Done delivered us time and time again. Done spared our lives. Done fed us when we were hungry. Gave us a better job. Gave us a new start. Done helped us over and over and over again. And we still act as if though God.
Amen.
Just some figment of somebody. Shameful to know him personally. Some folk can't even call his name. You know what they say. The man upstairs, the good man. There's a lot of folk upstairs. And that's how I address people who I don't know by name. I say the man across the street, I don't know his name. But if I knew his name, I wouldn't say the man across the street. I'd just say Mr. Willie. What if he
diminished
us down to that?
Mm.
One of them boys in Pensacola. Y'all answer me. What if that's all he thought about us?
Uh-huh.
Like God, he knows about me. In case, I'm gonna be out of here, but
I got y'all now.
In case that example wasn't good enough, Jesus denounced Capernaum, which is known as Jesus' headquarters.
Yeah.
He said to them, Capernaum, which was a thriving city.
You
have been exalted all the way up to heaven.
Yes.
But you're going to be brought down all the way to hell. And I like that because the scripture says they that are first will wind up being last. And just because you're on top right now don't mean that's how it's going to be in the end.
Yeah.
Some of y'all that watch wrestling, y'all ain't saying that. Ain't it something high in wrestling or boxing? The person who done lost the whole which were done in you had been done in Sodom.
Yes.
Sodom would still be here today.
Amen.
Now, this is vicariously. Don't you mix up what he's saying here.
Yes.
He's giving some steps, and I'll break it down for you if you give me an extra minute.
Come on.
He's saying that Sodom was destroyed for being evil. They were destroyed for being wicked.
Yeah.
But if those evil and wicked people had an example of somebody to show them how to live a life that was not wicked and not evil, y'all understand that they would have changed from being wicked and evil, and they would have accepted the way of God, and God would not have to have to destroy them. But the scripture said, as Sodom and Gomorrah, the and the stink in the nostrils of God. Their sin was so wicked and they were so evil until it went all the way up to high heaven. And one thing about God that the scripture says, in time past, he winked at our ignorance. But God is commanding men everywhere to repent for their sin. You may not have known better when you were young, but you know better now. You know right from wrong, and you know that's a real God. And one of these days, you're going to have to stand before the judge. I told you we just got wrong responses. I respond when we're wrong, instead of just saying, I'm grown,
right,
or I got the cancer that can't help. And asking somebody to pray for us. Instead, we like to say, well, God is the only one, you know what we said, that can judge us. Maybe you said that before. If you haven't said it, surely you've heard somebody say that. God is the only one that can judge me. Can means has the ability or the wherewithal. You understand that? And when we say that, we put the wrong word there. Remove the word can, if you will, and just say God. Only God will judge, because judgment hasn't come. That means it's not going to come. God is going to judge all of us, and we have to know just because he's the only one that can, and he hasn't done it. Y'all understand that? No hell in hand put me in. No, his job is to tell you about both of them. It's your choice, but God got one to put you in. And when you reject what the preacher say, y'all ain't saying that. When you reject what the preacher say, you think God gonna send you no special delivery?
Amen.
Don't you think God gonna send no special angel to get your life?
Amen.
Y'all ain't saying no. We might turn cartwheels over it.
All right.
Well,
our heart.
Yeah.
We're not sowing God.
Yeah.
So the book says, he told them, it's going to be more tolerable for Sodom in the day of judgment than it will be for thee.
Yeah.
First off, I also want to make you know that in judgment, there's going to be degrees of punishment. You know, when I was in school, I was going to say high school, but I reckon low school too. But when I was in school, they had different punishments for different things. And some of you young people don't know nothing about it, but they used to have a parrot, they call a parrot, wood bowl, and they made them however they wanted to make them. And if you didn't want to call Karen, you didn't get the suspension, you took the licks. Because a lot of times you can sit by and they just hit you and they don't tell your mama nothing, you know. And you ain't gonna tell them, so they can hit you like they wanted to. But then some things you got more licks for, y'all understand, than you did for other things. Some stuff, you understand, some stuff they just hit you two or three times and that's it. You don't test the same face just to make the other chair don't do it. And then the other time that was stuff that even the licks wasn't enough, you had to go home. Different degrees of punishment. See, some kind of way we think everything gonna be even, and we just thinking that God gonna be understanding. He's doing all the understanding now, but when judgment come, understanding is gonna be gone like the wind. But God has the best understanding. He understands how many years he woke you up. He understands how many days he woke you up. He understands how many sermons you had. Somebody died this week. He understands. In 2 Peter, the 2nd chapter.
Yeah.
I know what y'all waiting for, but I don't know. Peter was talking about problems that were arising in the church. And the danger that the Christian believers faced with non-believers and evil-hearted and wicked people. And Peter reminds them that God will judge. And one thing about God, even when you can't see him, he knows who you are, and he knows where you are. See, some folk in order to judge you, y'all ain't saying nothing. Somebody else have to tell them where you were and what you did. But with God, the book said, he sits high and he looks low. The eyes of the Lord are in every place, beholding the evil as well as he says, shucks, if God was so into judgment, could judge so good and punish so good,
all right,
and he spared not, y'all gotta look at this now, y'all be thinking I said this, he spared not the angels that sin, but cast them down from heaven to hell. And deliver them into chains of darkness to be reserved unto judgment. This is the argument Peter's making.
My Lord.
Since you're thinking you're getting away with something. Since you're thinking God don't see you. Since you're thinking God lacked what he used to not like. Since you thank God that loosened up and enlightened us.
Yeah.
Have mercy, man.
We spared not the old world.
Yeah.
Noah was preaching. Telling the people it's gonna rain. But you don't have to be destroyed.
Amen.
I'm building a place.
Yeah.
Where if you just come on the inside.
All right.
Yes, Lord.
You'll be all right.
Yes.
And after all that preaching and all that building, the book said it was only 8 people to be saved.
Amen.
Including Noah.
Amen.
And God destroyed the whole world.
Yeah.
Destroyed them for being ungodly.
Yeah.
You do know what ungodly means.
Yeah.
You understand that? He destroyed them for not being God-like.
Yeah.
He destroyed them for not being like God.
Yeah.
See, he made man in his own image, but yet he gives man a choice.
Yeah.
He made man in his likeness, but yet he gives man a choice.
Yeah.
He says, behold this day, I set before you both good and evil. I would that you choose.
All right, yeah.
I set before you both life and death.
Amen.
I would that you choose life.
Yeah.
And yet God destroyed the whole world.
Yeah.
And then he says, listen, bringing in the flood upon the world of the ungodly and turning the cities of Sodom and Gomorrah into ashes, condemn them with an overthrow, making them an example to those that would choose to live ungodly.
Yeah.
And then he says that although God destroyed the whole cities, he delivered just Lot. Now this word just does not mean only Lot.
Amen.
But this word just means just as in justified, as in righteous. God destroyed a whole wicked city and spared the life of one man who was righteous. So what he's saying, God knows how. Listen, because you know they tell this joke about the folk talking about, well, you know, if you don't want to fly in the plane because even if it's right with you, you know, if God angry with the pilot and God let the plane go down, God know how to let the plane go down. Don't nobody die but the person who want to die. God ain't got to kill me to get to you. Y'all ain't saying. Some of us got a bad shot. We might be shooting at somebody over there and hitting somebody over there. But God's not a perfect man. God ain't a shot. Destroyed the cities of Sodom and Gomorrah. And saved just Lot. Who was vexed every day with the filthy conversation of the people around him.
Amen.
I said that Sodom didn't have churches. Sodom didn't have no Bible. Only one man who was trying to live right. And the way of the scripture, although Peter refers to him as just, y'all ain't saying no. The scripture give all indication that Lot had backslidden. And it's one thing to have somebody trying to minister to you who is still just right with God. Somebody who is still giving it their all and all. But to only have somebody who know God and they don't know him, they done backslid too far to be able to tell you anything. The evidence is, the scripture said, when Lot told his son-in-law, get out of this city.
Amen.
It's getting ready to burn down.
Amen.
The book said, they looked at him as one that mocked. In other words, they didn't take him serious. In such a backslidden state. I told you before, when all you hang around is sinners. Y'all ain't saying that. Eventually, that's how you going to act. I heard the man saying concerning folk who are thrown in prison. Put a man the pen with hogs.
Yeah. All right.
And he eat with hogs and sleep with hogs. You need not think he's not going to get out and grunt sometime. You know what I'm saying? And whoever you hang around, particularly if you can't influence them, somebody is going to influence somebody.
Yeah.
And if they ain't going to be like you, y'all understand?
Yeah.
Are you going to be like them?
Yeah.
You got to first have something in common to start with.
Yeah.
But after that, whoever appear to be the strongest, that's who's going to prevail. And you'll find yourself using a different voice when you talk to certain folk because you're trying to be like them instead of getting them to be like you. Got different voices for where we at.
Yeah.
Different language for where we at.
Yeah.
I'm going to be me wherever I'm at.
Amen.
And I don't care how many folk I work with that don't look like me.
Uh-huh.
When time comes to talk, I'm going to talk like me. Y'all ain't saying that. Unless I mess around and slip up and talk wrong somewhere else. Y'all ain't saying that. I ain't gonna try to get proper because I'm talking to you. If that's how you talk, that's well. But you ain't gonna convert me to be like you. If I can't convince you to be what God is calling you to be, you're not gonna convince me to be anything less than what God is calling me to be. The love in his past was not enough
my Lord,
to convince Sodom to repent of that sin.
Amen.
Otherwise, he could not tell them that you all are perverse. Because he sat with perverse people all day.
Yeah.
He wouldn't have had nobody to say amen. Y'all ain't saying that.
Yeah.
He'd have been like I am today. He wouldn't have had no witness. He wouldn't have had nobody to say go on, go ahead, say it on. Because had he told them how perverse they were. And that is saying majority rule.
Yeah.
And I'm so afraid because Christians and believers are not the majority,
yeah,
but we have become the minority.
Yeah.
Everybody that come out the closet and Christians have gone in the closet.
Yeah.
You ought to stand for God or you will fall for the devil. For God I'm not here and for God I die. I'm not going to take down. I'm like this.
Uh-huh.
Forget about the rest of the world.
Yeah.
We've got more churches in Pensacola, Florida.
Yes.
Than there were in the whole Bible.
Amen. Amen.
We've got more bishops on the east side. My Lord, that could have ever been imagined. And Sodom had no church. They had a reason. They had an excuse to live any kind of way. But you and I don't have no excuse. God the good. He gave us his word. He gave us a place of worship. He gave us a preacher. Bibles.
Amen.
But it Europe, but they didn't have T.D. Jakes.
Amen.
All right. The Bible when Jesus died and went in the grave, he preached to the spirit. So even though they died, what we call untimely death, when Jesus preached to their spirit, if they received him, they were still allowed to go to heaven.
Hallelujah.
Everybody understand that?
Yeah. Yes,
sir. Everybody you read about over here, some folk died some strange deaths.
Yeah.
Some folk died some deaths that didn't seem fair.
Amen.
But every one of them.
Yeah.
When Jesus died, an even stranger death. Y'all ain't saying. When Jesus died, an even more unfair death. When he went in the grave, he preached to the saints. He preached to the spirit of the dead.
Yes.
He had an opportunity.
All right.
For eternal life.
Yeah.
Now let me make my point.
All right.
That was the Old Testament.
Right. Yes.
Every person born after the death of Jesus.
Come on.
It would be correct to say you get one chance.
Amen.
Now, I know that when they stretch you out right here, it done got easy to find folk who make it look like you was a good person.
Yes.
It's easy to find people who will put you in heaven in
there. Amen.
You understand? It's easy to find people who thank God is so loving and so forgiving. Until even though you didn't accept him, you're going to make it in anyhow. You understand that? But I have to tell you before you die, once you leave this life, you won't be back no more. Won't be no redoing. When you hear preaching again, when you get woke up again, it's going to be to stand before the judge. And he's going to say, give an account of yourself. And I know that right now, if they ask you, why you don't serve the Lord? I know you can use me as a cop out. You can just tell them Liam ain't no good. You can tell them grace and truth were just hypocrites. Tell them whatever you want to tell them. But when you stand before the judge, the judge is going to say, yeah.